This comes as local leaders now work to remove emergency powers from Erie County Executive Mark Poloncarz. We dive deeper into that issue, talking to some Republican state senators tonight.
As policymakers, we must acknowledge that residents are anxious because there appears to be no end in sight.
Two Republican state senators, one goal: make sure those in power making decisions have checks and balances to follow.
Our system, our founding fathers, the system was never designed to have one individual with unilateral control of any level of government, whether it's a state, whether it's city, county, city, town, or village.
Senator Ed Rath and Senator Patrick Gallivan are introducing a bill that would require any public official, like a county executive, who is extending on their own a state of emergency or executive order, have to go before their respective legislative board, such as the county legislature, first to make the case as to why and get it approved.
Do what I say is not how you build trust, and is certainly not a way to build community consensus.
They're referring to this 1,244 pages of executive orders and emergency order extensions done unilaterally since March of 2020 by Erie County Executive Mark Poloncarz, which gives Poloncarz the exclusive right to make executive orders on his own, such as the new mask mandate.
Are you aware of any other counties in the state of New York that are still under a state of emergency for the COVID-19 pandemic?
No.
There are other counties in western New York that have a higher positivity rate than Erie, like Cattaraugus County at 12%. In Chautauqua County, the state of emergency was dropped in the summer when the state dropped it as a whole. In Niagara County, for example, County Chairwoman Becky Wittish says, while we are certainly concerned about rising COVID-19 numbers in Niagara County, we are not implementing any mandates at this time. First, unlike Erie County, Niagara County is not under a state of emergency and has not been for months. This means any decision on new COVID-19 restrictions would require a vote by the legislature in consultation with our Director of Public Health. When asked about this issue, County Executive Mark Poloncarz said those other counties,
"Oh, and I know it's going to get them pretty angry. They're acting reckless by not implementing appropriate standards. If they want to talk about freedom, they can have the freedom to die or let their constituents die, but I think it is reckless."
The county executive says he kept his emergency powers to deliver vaccine clinics.
Now, in response to the county executive's statements, Niagara County Chairwoman Becky Wittish says, "It is truly disappointing that Mark Poloncarz would choose to call Niagara County reckless over a policy difference on how best to handle the increase in COVID-19 cases across the region. We have no interest in turning this into a political hot potato between neighboring counties."